Okay, so we are talking about statistics. First of all, how you define statistics? If you look at the singular word statistic, it means a single observation. For example, height of a person, 160 centimeter. So 160 single observation is called as what? Statistic. If you look at the plural word statistics, it means a collection of observations which you called as what? Data. For example, heights of all 50 students in my class. So I have 50 observations. So that group of 50 observations is called as what? Statistics. But the word statistics can also be used as a singular noun. And whenever it is used as a singular noun, it means a branch of science, a science of figures, which deals with numbers. There are four major functions in statistics. The first function is collection of data. So statistics will tell you how to collect the data. See, collection of data is not that much simple. For example, suppose you want to study the relationship between the smoking habits and the development of lung cancer. This is your study topic. And for this, you have to interview the smokers. If you go to a person, if you ask him, do you smoke? What is the probable answer? The probable answer is no. Even if that person is a smoker, he would say no. This is what you call as wrong response, and this is very dangerous. So while collecting the data, you'll have to deal with such wrong responses. So statistics will tell you what are the scientific techniques to collect the data. That is the first important function the statistics deals with, collection of data. Once you collect the data, second important function is presenting the data. Okay, whatever the data is collected, that we call as a raw data, unprocessed data. Now we start processing it so that we can draw some valid conclusions from it. So the first step in the processing is called as what? Presenting the data. You can present the data in the form of tables or graphs or charts or diagrams. So these are the different methods of presenting the data. Third function is called as what? Analysis. We are going to analyze the data. There are many scientific methods to analyze the data. There are two important parts of that. One is called as descriptive statistics. In descriptive statistics, we are going to describe the data. There are different measures of describing data. For example, the measures of central tendency. You must have heard about mean, median, mode. Those are called as measures of central tendency. What do they tell us? They tell us about the center of the data. Where does the center of the data lies? That is given by these measures of central tendency. But many times, the measures of central tendency is not sufficient to compare the groups. In that case, we go for the next measure, which we called as the measures of dispersion. So standard deviation, then coefficient of variation, quartile deviation. These are some of the measures of dispersion. Okay, so this we called as what? Descriptive statistics, where we are going to describe the data. Second important part of the analysis, which is called as what? Inferential statistics. In inferential statistics, we are talking about the different statistical tests. There are Z-test, T-test, chi-square test, ANOVA test, so many tests are there which are going to analyze your data in the form of interpretation. Okay, and the fourth important function is called as what? Interpretation of the data, where we are going to interpret the results we obtain. So these are the four important functions of the statistics: collecting the data, after collection, representing the data, then analyzing the data, and the last important function is interpretation of the data. So these are the four important functions of statistics. Okay, next. So statistics helps in measuring the chance variation in conclusions, that is amongst observed differences, by applying valid statistical test. Applicable only if the sample is random and its representativeness is ascertained. This is very important. All the statistical techniques are applicable only if the sample is randomly selected. Randomness is very important. All the probability models are used only when the sample is a randomly chosen sample. Next. Remember always, statistics in itself does not prove or disprove anything. It measures the chance of having come across with the similar findings if same experiment or the study is repeated multiple times under the similar circumstances. This is very important. Statistics is not going to prove or disprove anything. It will tell you only the chance, the probability that you come across the same results if you repeat the same experiment under the same circumstances. Okay, now we go for what? Sampling. See, when you undertake any study, first of all you have to decide your population under study. Let us take the similar example of finding the relationship between the smoking habits and the development of lung cancer. In this case, what is my population or the target population? The target population will be all the people who do smoke. The group of smokers will be what? Population. But many times what happens ki population is very big. And then you can't observe each and every element of that population because it may be time consuming, it may require more money, it may require more manpower. So in terms of time, money and manpower, it is not possible to observe the entire population. Okay, when you observe the entire population, that method is called as what? Census. For example, the census of India. Every 10 years, the census of India is carried out, where each and every individual in the India is observed and recorded. But this is not possible for all the studies. Okay, in that case, we go for what? Sampling. What is the advantage of, census method? There are no errors. But this, it has limitations. So we go for what? Sampling. Now, what is the sampling? What is a sample? Sample is a small part of the population which we actually observe, which we actually study. That small part from the population is called as a sample. And the technique by which we draw such a sample from the population is called as what? Sampling. See, for example, suppose a class is going on and an inspector comes to inspect the class. And if that inspector says to teacher, ask the question to the students, then what that teacher will do? That teacher will ask the question to only those students who knows the answer very well. And if the inspector makes some conclusion about the performance of the class depending on these answers given by the selected students, then that conclusion may be wrong. Why? Because here the sample is not randomly chosen. So selecting the sample from the population is not that much easy. So first you have to decide how to draw the sample. Second important aspect is what? What should be the appropriate sample size? Because sample size plays very important role in your decision making. If your sample size is not appropriate, your conclusions may be wrong. For example, this was an incident say 50 years back. At that time, no antibiotics were available for typhoid. And the mortality rate of the typhoid was much higher, around 70%. Means the 70% patients would die due to typhoid. Only 30% survived. Now, there were two doctors. The one was the experienced one, the old one, the skilled one. And the other doctor was comparatively new, not that much experienced, not that much skilled. Now, what happened? Ki three patients who are suffering from typhoid, they went to the skilled doctors, old doctor, and the three patients who are suffering from typhoid, they went to the new doctor. Now, all the three patients who went to the old doctor, they were very severe. The old doctor treated them, but all the three died. The three patients who went to the new doctor, they were from that 30% region. It means they are not that much severe. The new doctor treated them and all the three get cured. Now, what is the success rate of the old doctor? Three patients went to him, all the three died. So, success rate becomes what? Zero. What is the success rate of the new doctor? Three patients went to him, all the three cured. So, the success rate is what? 100%. So, can we say that the performance of the new doctor is better than the performance of the old doctor? Can we conclude from this? Like this? No. Why? What is the major problem with this? The major problem is the sample size. Only three patients were taken, So we cannot make any valid comparison between the two groups with the sample of size 3 only. This is how the sample plays a very important role in your study. So statistics will tell you what will be the appropriate sample size. And once you decide the sample size, statistics will tell you how to draw the sample from the population. So this is what the sampling we have. We have a universal population. Then from that we have to decide our study population, and from that we get a sample. Next, see about the sample size. Smaller the sample, greater the variation and lesser is the precision. See, sample size plays very important role. If the sample size is small, there will be greater variation and the lesser is the precision. Precision will be less. Larger the sample size, greater is the precision, less the bias. If the sample size is more, there will be less likely to make errors. So precision will be more. There is no magic figure for sample size. It will depend upon the nature of the problem under study. There is no magic figure. Most of the times students say that what sample size, 30 will be okay, 50 will be okay. No, it all depends upon what nature of the problem you are studying. That is very important, and from that you have to calculate. Next. Now these are the methods of sampling, how to draw a sample from the population. There are two techniques, probability technique and the non-probability technique. In probability technique we have simple random sampling, systematic sampling, stratified sampling and cluster sampling. In non-probability we have convenience judgment and quota sampling, but make sure that non-probability sampling techniques are not used in the further statistical analysis. So if you want to use the statistical techniques, your sample must be random, which is drawn from one of these methods. Now the first method is simple random sampling. Now as the name suggests, it's a very simple method to draw a sample from the population. Okay, but it has limitation. The simple random sampling technique is used only when the population is small and the population is homogeneous. Homogeneous means what? Whatever the characteristic you are observing, that characteristic must be uniformly distributed all over the population. That is what we call as homogeneous population. There we use what? This simple random sampling technique. Now the simple random sampling technique is similar to what? The lottery method. Now you already aware of the lottery method. Now what is lottery method? Suppose there are 100 persons and I want to select 10 out of them. So how do you select the 10 out of 100 by lottery method? We make the cheats. We make 100 cheats. We write the names of all the persons on those 100 cheats. Then all the cheats are shuffled and then we take out one by one 10 cheats. Whatever the name written on the selected cheats, those persons will get what? Selected. So this is what we call as lottery method, which is nothing but the simple random sampling technique. Okay, but when the population size is larger, suppose there are 1000 persons or 10,000 persons, then this lottery method fails. In that case, we are going to make use of random numbers. Random numbers table. Either you can generate the random number with the help of calculator, or you can also generate the random number with the help of computer MS Excel, or the random number tables are also there in statistical tables, just like this. So from this you can read the random numbers. For example, how you read the random numbers? Now to read the random numbers, first you have to decide what size of random number you require. Suppose you require two digited numbers. Then you have to read out what two digited numbers. For that what you do? You put your finger anywhere blindly. The digit beneath your finger will be your starting point. And from that starting point, you start reading the two digited numbers. For example, suppose I start from this number, 2. Okay, this is my starting point. So what will be my first random number? 23. Next will be 8. Next will be 23, then 5, then 25, then 1, then 43, 99, 65. This is how I go on reading the random numbers. Once I comes at the end, 71, then 05, then I go up there, 33. 65, 11, 49, 22, like this. This is how we read the random numbers from this random number table. And these random numbers are used to draw a simple random sample from the population. But as I told you, simple random sampling technique is very simple or easy to conduct, but it has limitations. It is useful only when the populations are small and the populations are homogeneous. But in real life situations, the populations are not small. Also, the populations are not homogeneous. The populations are big and the populations are heterogeneous. So for such populations, big and heterogeneous populations, we are going to use the next technique, which is called as systematic sampling. The most popular technique is called as systematic sampling. The systematic sampling is useful. There is one condition for applying the systematic sampling. The condition is what? You must have the list of all the elements or all the individuals in the population with you. For example, suppose in a village there are 1,000 houses and you go for the survey in that village, but you are not going to observe all the 1,000. You want to select only 100 houses out of 1,000. In that case, we will be using this systematic sampling. In the systematic sampling, what we do? Only the first element is selected randomly and the remaining all will be selected automatically or systematically with the interval k. Now, what is that k? The k is obtained as population size upon sample size. That is called a sampling interval. Population size n upon sample size n. That is your k. Now, suppose the first element selected randomly is r. Then the next will be r plus k. Next will be r plus 2k. Next will be r plus 3k, like this. This is how every kth element will be selected. And therefore that k is called as what? Sampling interval. So this technique is called as what? Systematic sampling, applicable whenever the populations are big, heterogeneous, but you should have the complete list of the population with you. The next technique is called as stratified random sampling. Now see, what is stratified random sampling? Stratified sampling is again used whenever the populations are very big. In that case, what we do? First we divide the entire population into different groups according to the convenience of the investigator. For example, suppose I am the investigator and I found that for my study purpose, the educational status of the person is very important. Then I will divide my population according to the educational status. For example, one group of the people who are illiterate, one group who are having only primary education, one group who are having secondary education, one group of the graduates, one group of the postgraduates, like this. So this is how I divide the population into the different groups. Or for example, suppose for my study purpose, the economical status is very important. Then I will divide the population according to economical status. For example, one group of the people whose monthly salary is less than 5,000. One group between 5 to 10,000, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30, and more than 30,000. This is how I divide the population into the different groups. So investigator decides how to make the groups. So even if the population is very big, first you have to divide the population into the different groups, and these groups are homogeneous within. Then what we do? Then from each group, we draw a random sample by simple random sampling technique. For example, in the first group there are 100 persons. So from the 100, I will select 10 with random sampling. From the second group, I will select 20 by random sampling. This is what we called as stratified sampling. So in stratified sampling, first divide the population into the different groups, homogeneous groups, and then from each group we take some elements by simple random sampling technique. So that is called as stratified sampling technique. Okay, so this is how the statistics, mainly we talk about what statistics can do. Now we know that statistics is a major subject. Statistics is a core science subject which has many applications in the real life situations. Okay, so we'll be discussing all this in details in the next lecture.